Recent research suggests that the coronavirus may survive on airborne aerosols for a few hours. That's one reason the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention now recommends Americans wear cloth face coverings to help slow the spread of the coronavirus. Dr. Yang Wang, assistant professor of environmental engineering at Missouri S&T, studies how fine particles like aerosols are transmitted.
So we started these tests and actually identified a few types of filtration material that might work well as the filtering material for masks and respirators.
The students brought us some common non-medical materials, such as the air filters, furnace filters, HEPA filters, and also coffee filters.
So to test the performance of these filtering materials, we first cut them into small discs and then insert them into a device called the filter holder. And then we'll introduce aerosols to challenge its performance. So what we use is an instrument called scanning mobility particle sizer that can measure particle size and concentration. So we use this instrument to measure both the particle size distribution before the filtration and after the filtration.
So for the pillowcases test, we tested four layers, but the highest efficiency is just around 60%. So if you want to make your DIY mask out of a fabric, you have to fold so many layers, but you also need to make sure that you can still breathe.
When we make our own masks, we have to make sure that there is a tight seal between the mask and our face. I think a combination of the fabrics and the air filters might be a good way to go. As for the commercialized air filters, one concern we have is that the small fibers might be generated when we're trying to cut or fold these air filters. And then if we breathe those tiny fibers into our lungs, that may cause some respiratory diseases. So what we recommend to do is actually to insert these air filter layers into the fabric materials or the fabric masks we make at home. And also we need to make sure that there are multiple layers of these fabrics surrounding these air filters. And in this case, we can form safer types of the masks and also guarantee a relatively high filtration efficiency. When we look back, we can summarize what we have learned from all the different scientific subjects, and all of us can get better prepared for the future.